DCW, and SDeems. SDeems.
So this will be, Marth.
Should I just go straight into it? Yeah. Never mind. I'm gonna dance around for a little bit.
Usually Marth's favor, from what I've seen and heard. Probably 60-40 though. I don't think it's that bad. Might be 65-35.
La la la. Blah 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 blah.
Oh, hand warmers.
He's already.
Not sure what.
Hand warmers. Hand warmers. Blah.
A little bit of passion around.
The funny thing is, like, sometimes in hand warmers, you see these guys do these incredible things, and I sometimes wonder if it's. Because sometimes you never even see them use this kind of stuff in the game. I always wonder if it's an intimidation factor by some things. Just like, hey, this is what I can do. But then sometimes you just never even see it.
They're just like, I love to move. A lot of this game is just people loving to move. But yeah, also, like, I guess it's just their hands being used to, like, all different directions, all different stuff. Just like, platform landing, or, wavelength, you know. And SDeems takes the hand warmer.
Speaking of which, we'll figure it out that probably a little later when we figure out when the next tournament will be, but again, as always, we keep them at 496 Baxter Street. This is Athens, Georgia, and this is Winners Finals today. We got DCW versus SDeems, Marth versus Sheik.
You're going to see a lot of space in
this. Ninja versus a swordsman. We've seen this from DCW. Those tippers are just relentless. These guys are just really tight on them. And this is Marth's stage. It really is.
Yeah, I think Marth has a huge advantage.
Because he knows how to get some of those tippers from all the platforms. I mean, if you're sitting on top, he might be able to hit you. And that range meet, you can just sit there. You're not even safe on a platform if you're above him, you know, next to him. You gotta be either right in him or just far away from Marth. You gotta make Marth play to you. And Sheik.
Yeah, you really gotta make Marth come to you. Yeah. Which is really hard because you won't.
I think that neutral air was not helpful. He wanted to grab the ledge and probably follow up from that. I think that was probably a missing clip that happened afterwards. So far right now, we got a tied up game though.
Dude, Randall's all part of this.
SDeems is able to help. Is able to help tie it up right now by getting a kill on Marth. Help himself by getting a kill. Alright, a little up tilt. DI to get away from that.
That grab is exactly what Sheik's looking for right now.
It was a little early, unfortunately.
Dude, everyone's planning on Randall.
I think that up smash was probably just a little too, way too early on Marth right now. With Marth, it was only about like 10% when she was trying to do that. There's more optimal things to follow up with that.
That's true, just crouch cancel it at that point.
As we said before, like, I've seen all these guys do these crazy hand warm stuff, and then I never see them really do it in the game. I've not seen them roll. It's not that rolling is a bad thing by any means in Melee, but I always just know that when you do roll, it's usually out of nervousness. So,
yeah,
I think SDeems is starting to get a little. I don't want to say shooken, but he's starting to get a little. He had a couple of panic moments right now.
Yeah, the most.
Dolphin Slash out of shield.
They got it.
Shitty!
Definitely a miss him, but.
Easy, Mewtwo King. Easy. There's a forward smash. Not even the tip, but just the hilt. But
it's not
high enough. That's going to take it. Forward smash. Or start forward tilt. Well, down smash. And that's the bad thing about Sheik's down smash. It just doesn't do too much.
Yeah.
But good ledge game right there by SDeems Sheik.
His down smash and his up smash basically cover the same ground.
Yeah.
Not really great.
At least with up smashes.
It's a kill move.
It's a little faster too.
I think definitely throws him away further.
That's gonna be the first game. DCW takes it with a couple extra stocks to be able to do it with. As far as where they're gonna go next, I'm very curious because I mean I would imagine Sheik just needs a little bit more room to work with. So Greenland seems like a good idea, yeah.
Sure. Yeah, that's fair.
Keep that space right now. DCW is really controlling neutral, but needles are pressure, and seen a little bit there, but I mean, he's got all the time in the world to build them up even more. Maybe he doesn't want them all charged up, because then, I mean, at the same time, if you charge them all up, then you got to throw them all out, and that takes a lot longer to throw than compared to one.
So yeah, he should be charging all that. Should be charging for sure.
But off stage, though, now, I mean, that's when you get the chance to actually get.
His needle edge cards are nice, though. That turnaround.
Yeah, he's got a wise choice for SDeems. It's really hard. You can see that's already helping him right now.
For sure. Especially because the platforms are like are too high for most of Marth's regular
platforms are much lower. Marth has all the room in the world to hit you with a forward smash, or even just an up tilt or even an up smash, you're gonna get hit. But this is somewhat tied, but still I think a lot of the favorite stills right now is in SDeems. Making it much more difficult for DCW to really stay on him. He's really just keeping it a little bit more of a distance game, waiting for DCW to make a mistake and then follow up. Good DI to get away from that Marth hit after following the grab.
Yeah. Really got away from an opening on Sheik.
Dash pokes. There's that reverse forward smash. And there's another one, and that one does take the kill, unfortunately. And now I'm starting to see a couple little things from SDeems right now. Nervousness starting to set in. He's got to get that mentality back.
Marth just makes getting in there so hard.
I mean, you're playing, it's, you know, you're a six foot person versus Shaq. I mean, he's got the wingspan. He doesn't even have to jump to dunk the ball, and that's what he's got with that sword right there. Marth is the Shaq of the game, pretty much, it feels like. He doesn't have to do too much as far as reaching. And then there's other things as far as jank with Marth, because his dash grab is longer than that of Yoshi's tongue, which is ridiculous.
Oh, his grab's crazy. We haven't been seeing that a lot.
He's actually been doing, like, relatively close grabs. We haven't seen, like, a mile-away grab yet.
Mostly because there's no reason for him to, because Marth can space so well for Sheik, and Sheik's really just looking for an opening, and that's what a missed grab by Marth will give him.
Oh,
like, there's no reason to really throw up.
Sheik was able to stop the Dolphin Slash. It's a very weird thing to do, because Dolphin Slash just comes out so fast.
Mm-hmm.
Now, SDeems up with the lead. Can he hold it and be able to take it in game three? Actually, it's winner's final, so are they going to be best of five? We'll have to see in just a minute. We'll know at least after this. If DCW does end up winning, we'll know after the game if we actually are going to game three.
It should be best of five. It'd be weird not to see a best of five set in winners.
People not really trying to juggle this game, but at the same time, it's there's only been one move I have not seen DCW use.
The transform?
Nope.
Oh, wait, no, I'm sorry. Yeah,
no, actually, I take that back. There's two moves. I haven't seen him do a down air, and I haven't seen him do neutral B.
He hasn't done dancing plays either.
He'll use it to help him recover. But I haven't seen him do the neutral or down air, so I didn't see the reverse Ken combo. I didn't see anything like that. So
that's true. We haven't seen any Ken combos.
Really, what we're seeing a lot of his stuff is he's really relying on his forward smash, his forward tilt, or not forward tilt, his forward smash, his down tilt, and his forward air.
Now that I think about it, we haven't seen a lot of aerials from DCW.
He's playing a lot of ground game.
Yeah.
Which will be interesting, because, I mean, that's, again, with Marth, he wants to pick something where he's much more grounded. And he already started off on Yoshi's story, so we're not going to be able to, unfortunately, go back there. And that was the best possible level, probably, for Marth to use. So where are we going to go? We're going to go to...
Probably...
We're going to go to...
Probably Battlefield?
That's what I was going to guess. If not, maybe Dreamland. Even.
Yeah.
Or not Dreamland. No, Fountain Dreams. Here you can really just stay on the ground game. This is where she can get it. She can't play on the platform, so this is going to be definitely Marth's stage. So let's see what ends up happening from here. So far, Sheik's actually been kind of controlling the neutral, though.
Yeah, this is actually going to be super rough for Sheik.
Same time, though, this is what she really needs to use the needles. This is what SDeems really needs to use the needles just to really get that space going. Oh! Nice little hit from the vanish. Those down tilt pokes by Marth are just... I mean, okay, there's a little follow-up right there. Forward and aired into neutral. I only get one little spot.
Ooh, that was
right.
Nice.
Follow up. There we go. Should see something up air. Didn't chase him down in the air as much as I was hoping he would try to. Just try to keep some kind of pressure on him. He back the ledge.
He definitely should have found something like persisting out right there.
That seems just respecting him way too much.
DCW to not get that edge guard.
You'll see too many jabs these days, but I mean, it's starting to come out a little bit more. People are starting to try and figure out things that they can do outside of the jab.
Yeah.
Okay, next forwarder, that should be able to... Oh, well, it is Marth, though. So
that's it?
That should, okay, yeah. It's weird that Marth can actually is able to recover sometimes that far. Okay, good work with the needle stun for a second. Okay.
Oh, no chain grab. Yeah, I don't know where the
chain grab. The up smash is not worth it when Marth is only at 14%.
I haven't seen either of these players go for any chain grabs. Really, like...
That is one of the greater differences of Smash 4 and Smash Melee, is that there's something called the Q in Smash 4, where if you use a move, it stales out after a while until like 9 other moves, including itself, come out.
Yeah, we have two. We have two moves.
Okay, yeah.
It's still chain grabs don't. I mean, you can still do chain grabs on your stale moves.
Okay. That's looking for that forward smash right there. And there's still
it either knocks down its damage or its knockback. Maybe both.
Okay, good ledge gimping right there from SDeems. He's actually making much more use of Final Destination than I was expecting, honestly. It's shown that SDeems actually has been doing some really good groundwork. He's figuring out how to, like, actually...
Yeah, I'm impressed by SDeems' ability to get in.
That could have been a bad thing right there. I don't know if it was a mix-up or just a missing right there. That could have been a bad thing. DCW could have really taken advantage of that. Avoid the juggle. But that forwarder is going to connect.
Yeah.
Forward smash.
That air dodge is bad.
Oops. Good shield pressure by Sheik going on Marth right there. Good shield pressure. Can we get it? Okay. Up tilt. Let's hold the first chain grab.
There it is. This should be it. Good snipe.
Good snipe, but it's a little too close right there. Looking for a forward air, probably. Oh, yeah, really? Just shielding. He's fishing for a hard. Ooh. Here comes.
Yeah. That down tilt's
up air.
That down tilt up air is so sick. Pretty good combo.
That's two. That team takes it on the counter pit. That's a hard thing to do right there, man. That's a hard thing to do. Is, you know, when you lose the previous one and somebody takes it to a different game. So now DCW's like, okay, well, that didn't work. Do we want to go back again? Or does he want... I honestly think if he takes it to...
If he takes
it to Dreams, I think he'll have a better advantage because with the platforms going up and down, he might be able to do some stuff.
I don't know. Battlefield's really good for Marth. Depending on your Marth. Battlefield or
Pokemon Stadium, he could hope for some of the janky stuff to come up.
I wouldn't go for Pokemon Stadium just either. I would say that's in Sheik's favor.
I mean, it just depends how which one is up for him. I mean, because it looks like he was looking at it for a second.
Yeah.
He's thinking about it. He's going, yep. Let's think about it. Like, again, he wants to go for, like, the bird pit or the,
some must like the platform or some down.
I mean, you can do some stuff there.
Preference.
And Marth has, it's kind of like the Yoshi Story platforms, too. They're low enough where you can do some stuff with them. And he's doing stuff with them.
It's true.
63, no response so far from SDeems, except for one little needle that takes on 3%. A little dash dance, but doesn't commit all the way through. And he's poking. Poke.
Yeah.
What is this, Facebook? 2005?
Damn. That was nice. Great stuff by DCW.
Alright, so DCW is really gonna. It's really taking advantage of this counter pick right now. The fearful part, though, is.
Whoa!
That's my only thing I really hate about Pokemon Stadium. I mean, there's several things I hate, especially like Jank, where you can fall through the middle once in a while, but the one thing I really hate is that you just can't see off the ledge.
Okay.
I just hate that.
What about the transformation infinite?
Oh,
it's on this.
It's gonna shit still there.
Are they just gonna wait it out?
They're gonna wait it out. They're just gonna taunt it out.
That's fair.
This 30 seconds of rock platforms is brought to you by Pizza Hut.
Rock mode.
496 Baxter Street. Baxter Street, Pizza Hut. Where rock transformations happen. change? Nah, I'll just go back to the neutral. That's respectable. I mean, that's fine.
Preferably, I usually fight out the transformations.
It was honestly a bad situation for Sheik to want to try and do that because Marth was in the spot where Dolphin Slash will just ruin your day.
Oh, right. So I wouldn't go.
And he was
after
saying,
Marth,
DCW is hiding behind that rock. Like, come on over. I got a little Dolphin Slash for you to have some fun with. And it's just a smart on both.
Yeah. I definitely fight on the right side.
If you're on the right side, that for Sheik would
I don't hide
right
line.
Just being able to slap you back and forth, back and forth, back and forth.
You know, we got different ideas as players.
That's fine. They had that mutual agreement that sometimes it happens and you just say, wait for the rain to pass and here we go, then we'll get
all fair.
That's a good call. Yeah, he threw him off, put him into an up tilt, juggle him, three. That's three juggles in the air. That's what I'd like to see SDeems do a little bit more with his cheek rather than try to commit to like an up smash. Then he could actually have some follow ups. Let's see what he does.
Ooh.
Better.
That was a good
better.
That was a good mix up. Those cheeks would go out on the platform, you waited it out. Do mix up.
I like that little trade off. I mean, DCW showed his, SDeems showed his. They both had pretty much kind of like the same kind of follow up, the grab into something. Alright, now we got windmill level. I don't know who this favors, to be fair.
Ooh.
Maybe.
Down air, up air.
Man. DCW on his turn on his winner stock right now.
SDeems has really good follow ups into up air. We've seen down tilt for him, we've seen down air for him, and then he puts both into a kill move with up air.
The longer they play, SDeems just settle into these things. He's been becoming much more comfortable. And he's starting to realize as far as his patience really paying off, and he's not getting hit by these rogue forward smash, but man, those pokes.
Yeah, he's
pokes.
Super figured this out.
He's really getting around it.
Really impressive.
And part of it, too, is also you're just seeing DCW not do as much air work as SDeems. I mean,
no, not at all.
These guys, we've seen a couple of Marth players earlier today, but they've been really relying just more on the forward tilt rather than trying to make something else happen. And with these platforms, this is the opportunity a lot of times where you can do that reverse Ken combo or just get them in the air and then just get that down air. I have not seen a single down air at all from DCW.
No down airs. Zero.
That's a bad move, mind you. You just have to find the right spot for it, and that's the spot right there. But you just have to maybe practice to commit it. But this
back
juggle stuff has been crazy, I'll say that.
Good grab.
So it's down air.
That should,
that forward air could have done it, though. He's looking for
good stuff.
Rarely do I ever see something beat a Dolphin Slash, but a forward air apparently today has done it twice.